So if you're going to treat your patient prone on a belly board, we discussed how to get the patient positioned. Getting on and off of the belly board, that's another issue entirely. But once you have the patient on the belly board, you want to have them such that their symphysis is at the edge of the belly hole. You want the symphysis at the superior edge of the inferior opening of the belly board. So, you have the opening of the belly board right here. This is the inferior edge. You want the symphysis as superior as possible toward the inferior edge, but not in the hole. You don't want the patient's pelvis inside the hole. That's not reproducible, and it's not something that you're ever going to be able to set up properly. So you want the symphysis, in this particular case, to be right on the edge of the inferior edge of the belly board hole. What that does is it allows the soft tissue, if she had soft tissue, of the belly to fall into the hole and thus fall anterior this direction from any treatment portals that you may have. This is typically done on a three-field technique. If you're treating for PA and two laterals, those laterals can be relatively large. You want the smallest amount of small bowel as possible to come in contact with that treatment field. So we do this so that it falls anterior to any lateral treatment fields. This is the most difficult treatment to set up and be reproducible because the patient feels vulnerable. Okay? We're going to line them up. They're face down. Everyone else's faces are at their posterior, and you're actually grabbing them and rolling them. So what they tend to do is they will tighten their gluteus muscles up and squeeze their hiney together. That's going to move your marks. So when you know that your patient has tightened up, you're going to have to try to get them to relax, which is difficult. A lot of times if you can roll their leg a little bit, it will make their muscles relax. Sometimes you have to actually show them where they're being tight. So really high on their glute muscle, you can actually touch them. Sometimes you can press on the very tip top of the gluteus muscle. And if you press there and tell them relax here, they will know what they realize what they're doing, they'll relax. And then as soon as you go to roll them again, they'll tighten right back up. So all we can do is what we can do with the patient. It's going to be very difficult for this person to relax in the first place, so you've got to just work with them. Same rolling techniques. You're going to have your hand. Once you put your hand on your patient, since they're face down, you want to put your hand that's away from you very high on their backside. You've got the iliac crest right about here, and then just down from there, your gluteus muscle kind of starts. That's usually where I put my hand, and I keep my hand open. Okay, we're not grabbing butts here. Just use the meat of your hand right there, grab the sheet, and roll. It's a difficult thing to learn, but it's something that will help you know if you're actually getting the patient to roll. If you're just lifting on the sheet, they're going to kind of lift up and lay back down again, especially if they're prone. You'll end up walking your patient laterally. So you want your hand relatively high so they don't feel like they're being violated in any way, and roll. Same way, if you're coming towards you, grab the sheet on the other side, hand open, roll. Gentlemen, especially, if you've got a female face down, or once we get to breast setups, a female face up, you want to be very delicate and very careful. You don't want there to be any misunderstandings. Be as professional as possible. If you do roll this patient, make sure your hand is open. Make sure that everyone in the room, including yourself, knows that you're not going to do anything by accident that is going to cause the patient to be even more uncomfortable than they already are. Hand open, high up, almost to the hip, roll. Sometimes you'll have a prone pillow. Sometimes you'll have just some kind of little pad for the person to lay on. Their arms will be up around their head. If she had arms, we would show you. You want the belly board itself to be relatively high on the table. If you don't, you're going to end up with the pelvis too low, and then you're going to run out of table before you get in far enough to actually do the treatment. So the board itself needs to be way up toward the top of the table. In this particular case, I have it hanging over. In this particular model, there's actually a slot here for a lock bar. And then here's a lock bar slot. So you can actually put the lock bar at the very top to make sure that you're in the same place every time. And very superior on the table, so that you don't run out of table length before you get to the treatment itself. Those are the most important things. Once again, symphysis. Superior edge of the inferior portion of the belly board. Not further down, not further up. Pelvis doesn't need to be in the hole. We also talked about one other thing. When you actually, in an actual treatment, you're probably going to have a sheet underneath the patient.